As much as I love modern toys and sharing videos with you guys on them, nothing excites me more than covering toy lines from my childhood, especially ones from 90s Kenner. So let's get ready to talk about some old toys. Bang! Hey guys and gals, I'm here with you video. Today it is part one of my Shadow reviews based on the toy line from 1994's The Shadow. As you can tell, the figures come on the same style card. The only difference is their little character that's featured on there. That's really it. This is your main Shadow you will get. A lot of them feature an offer to get a free agent hologram ring, which I have somewhere. I bought one a couple years ago when I was getting all of my Shadow stuff. I put it in a safe place, and now I don't know where that safe place is. I have it. It's somewhere, but it's basically just a little cheap plastic ring that would probably fit on my pinky if I'm lucky. As a little hologram sticker that says The Shadow, and it's meant to be like the agent rings that you have from the movie. Offer sadly expired though, so don't try to get one now. You go in the back, and you will have all of your figures in the line. We're gonna be covering all of those today, and then they feature instructions for how to play with your toy because we need it sometimes. But oh, look at that! Look at that good old Kenner logo. Let's go ahead and tilt you guys down a little bit. As with most toy lines, you got two categories for your figures. You got your heroes, and you got your villains. Of course, the main two being the Shadow himself and Shiwan Khan. And of course, like many toy lines from the 90s, whether they were comic book characters, movie lines, TV shows, what have you, we have variants. We have not one, two, three, four, but five different Shadow variants. And then we have two variants of Shiwan Khan, a Mongol warrior, and Dr. Mokino. And I admit, when you put them all together, it's not a bad looking display. It tickles me just seeing all these guys standing together because I had a bunch of these when I was little, but I didn't have all of them. But I get that they probably wouldn't have sold because they're just regular people, but it would have been great to have a Margot Lane, to have a Mo to drive the taxi cab that we have for the toy line, to have Tim Curry's character in figure form because he was one of the villains of the movie. Maybe even just some mobsters or some cops, just something. Because as it is, you got five Shadows, you got two bosses, and then two different villains, which Dr. Mokino wasn't even in the movie. He's a character from the Shadow serials and, like, I think, like, the radio plays and that kind of stuff. I'm not too up-to-date on my old Shadow stuff. I just really know the movie. So, yes, while I get that having generic citizens probably wouldn't have sold as an adult, I would like to fill this out with more characters from the movie because there are so many big-name actors that appeared in it. So let's break this down. Let's get started. We're going to start this off with the man himself. This is the Lightning Draw Shadow figure. This is the kind of default Shadow, and I had this one as a kid. I absolutely love having it again. His whole gimmick, a lot of the figures have gimmicks, but his, you put his pistols in his hand, you squeeze his legs, and he can draw his guns. It's lightning draw. It's lightning. And you can have some fun. You know, is he there? You shooting there. Oh, get him up there. You get him down there. Oh, he's all over. Ah! I love it. Now, when you're not playing with his guns, you can take them out and store them in his side holsters, which is always a nice thing. I always like when figures have storage for their weapons. And you have a decent little Shadow. I mean, he looks really nice. The legs can go forward. You know, they can't really go back. I mean, it has your standard 5 points of articulation. The arms don't really have much poseability because of his gimmick. That is unfortunate, but it's there. And I said 5 points. His head can't even move. So 4 points. You can take his cloak off if you so desire. Takes a little bit of maneuvering to get it off, but you can have your Shadow just on his own. Don't know why. He looks okay without it, but you really need the cape. And like most of his figures in this line, he does have light piping, which gives him a really nice glowing red eye look. I mean, you can even see it without the light going. Just my regular room light is showing, but that looks really nice. I like it. A kind of drawback, though, is that the way his legs are sculpted, you can't get him standing just straight up. You have to have his legs constantly kind of put in this kind of position, which isn't horrible, but it can make getting him to stand a little difficult. He does have holes in his feet, so if you do get some figure stands, you can get him going up, and it shouldn't be a problem. Next up is the transforming Lamont Cranston figure. This is the Shadow when he's not being the Shadow. Looks just like Alec Baldwin. It's a uncanny resemblance. All right, can I get you to actually stand? There you go. Okay, see, you got to get his legs all spread apart. So the whole gimmick with this is that he comes with snap-on armor bits, including a really interesting take on the Shadow. Instead of having his scarf, he has what appears to be kind of a respirator, a gas mask. I don't know. And you do have his guns, as you would expect. But for this one, you got Lamont's. It's what you would expect. His legs can go forward. They can actually go back this time, but it will take off his coattails, I think they're called. The arms have full rotation, and his head can move this time. And, you know, if he gets scared, he can pull a Ninja Turtle and just duck his head in. But, of course, the whole gimmick with this is we're going to turn him into the Shadow. So take off the coattails. You're going to take this, get it all fixed. Go ahead and put his head down. You don't really need to push it in advance, but I have a feeling if you just use this to push it down, you might scrape his nose up a little bit. So be careful. Don't know why I'm amazed by that. So push the head down. You're going to take this whole armor piece. It's going to fit over him. Clip it in place. You have these two little gloves, which I can't help but enjoy that the instructions for this say that he can hold his guns with or without the gloves. Because he has the exact same hands. And his guns just fit right into there. One of them's a little bit warped, but he holds it. Oh, no. He did hold it. There we go. Now he's back to how he's supposed to look. So again, articulation is very much the same as the other Shadow. He keeps the leg and arm movements, but his head is now completely static because of the whole armor gimmick. And as with before, he does have the light piping for his eye. So really, really nice glowing red eye effect. I'm going to put you right back there. Hope I can fit them all together. So up next is the Ambush Shadow. So this one makes sense because one of the Shadow's abilities is that he can cloud men's minds. He can make it where they can't see him. The only thing he can't hide is his shadow. So we do have a semi-transparent shadow. It looks like the dye from his cape is actually rubbing off or being absorbed by his hat. I got this mint in package. It was brand new. And I'm guessing over the years, maybe just the dye is just popping out and going into the hat. I don't know, but not a bad overall look. I do have to wonder if it's yellowed over time, if it was always this kind of look, but his whole gimmick is squeeze his legs and he draws his gun and pulls his cape over his face to kind of shield him. And of course, as with some of the other figures, you can take his cape, unclip it from his wrist, pull it off there. And see, I don't know if that can even be undone. But it's all along the sides of his neck, his hat. I don't know. You can take off his little chest piece. There we go. And it actually makes the figure, the instructions say you can actually pretend that he's, I don't know where it is now. this isn't funny. I've lost the figure because I took off its clothes. That's not good. So I'm just going to put those back there for now and hope I can find it later. So just, he's here. He's here somewhere. I just, like, I put him right here. I don't know. Anyway, one of the odder variants to me is this Ninja Shadow. We never kind of saw this in the movie. I don't know if the comics or the serials ever had him being a ninja. I have no idea. But you have your Ninja Shadow. So the instructions point out you're supposed to have this reversed where the back tab is facing front and his sides are on his back. It doesn't look right to me. They peg in at a really weird angle. It feels like it's putting strain on the rubber belt. And plus his cape just doesn't fit over him. So I do it in the front. You don't have to. But you can tell he comes decked out with a bunch of weapons. So let's go ahead and take the Psy out real quick. So he does have this big old staff, which he holds pretty well. You can take it out of his hand. Get out. Because the instructions, as they point out, he can hold his weapons in either hands. You can hold the Psy if you want. But the best feature is he has some nunchucks. And of course, when you squeeze his legs, I love it. I love it so much. But you could, of course, put a Psy in that hand. And, you know, It's not as effective. But as with some of the others, you can actually take his hat off. And you can take his cape off. And I gotta say, this cape, the plastic for this is a lot more rigid than the other. So pulling it off is kind of a challenge. And if you want, you could make this guy just a random ninja for the Shadow to fight. He could be a bad guy.
He could. It's, you know.
If you're desperate enough, just have the Shadow fight a ninja. That works. Let's go ahead and get him back dressed. As with the others, he of course does have the light piping as well. So there you go. It is a weird figure. It's not one of my favorites, but the whole nunchuck gimmick just works for me. It works so well.
Put you right up there.
And last but not least, some places call this Deluxe Shadow. Its official name is Bulletproof Shadow. This figure is insane. Just look at all the armor that he is decked out in. You may notice he does not have a light piping thing on the top, but he does have a big backpack with a speaker. His whole gimmick is you squeeze his legs and... I love it. I love it so much. I'm surprised this thing stores. That is the original battery or batteries that are in it. I probably should check to make sure they're not corroded, but he works. I got him in a package and he works perfectly fine. It's bizarre. It's very strange. But that's kind of what this toy line is. It's bizarre and strange. So one thing I've noticed with him, the plastic on him feels slightly sticky. The other figures don't have that problem. Oh, and you know what? You know what I just realized? I've never noticed this until now. I've wondered why his guns have little pegs on them. He's got holes in his legs. He's got magic legs. Look! You can store them on his sides, on his thighs. There we go. I never knew that. I'm literally just figuring this out now. So that is cool. I was kind of let down that he didn't have holsters for his guns, but he has leg storage. So now I'm wondering, let's, hey, that, don't fall over. Let's check out this guy. Does this guy have them? Ah, so Lamont doesn't have them. His guns also have the pegs. And I don't think Lightning Draw Shadow has them. Oh, getting him to stand is going to be a challenge now. There we go. I don't think Lightning Draw Shadow has them because he actually has the holsters. Yeah, so that's interesting that I've never noticed that before. So yeah, that's your look at the good guys from the Shadow toy line. I got him. Give me the cape. Give me that. I hope that joyride was worth it because you are not getting naked ever again. You hear me? You're going to wear your cape and your vest forever. But of course, what's the point of having good guys if you don't have bad guys for them to fight? So let's start with the main baddie himself, Shiwan Khan, the last descendant of Genghis Khan, as he is very, very proud to point out. So this figure's not bad. However, you could easily get a bunch of these and pretend these are his Mongol warriors because they wore the exact same armor as him. And he really doesn't wear his armor that much in the movie. He wears it when he's first shown, but then the rest of it, he's in either suits or just flowy robes. So you could very easily just take off his armor, have this be your Shiwan Khan, and then have all of your armor guys be his Mongol soldiers. I'm very, very tempted to do that because we need more bad guys. But when you put his armor back on, it doesn't really limit his articulation that much. His head obviously can't turn. You have to make sure you work the little grooves past his ponytail, which he didn't have in the movie. So, you know, that's that. But, you know, you can't really turn his head anymore. One nice detail is he actually does have his scar that he had in the movie. So I'm not sure that's something that was carried over from the comics, the strips, and the serials, whether Shiwan Khan had that scar or if that was something that is just from the movie. I don't know, but it's a nice detail that they haven't included. The arms can, of course, rotate, but they kind of get in the way with the shoulder armor. The legs can move pretty fine without it. He, of course, comes with his serpent staff, which if you push on the back, you can make it talk and go. He never had this in the movie. And a bizarre weapon to me. I thought all this time it was just a regular sword, but I found this is actually meant to be Herba, the dagger from the movie, the tri-bladed dagger, and it looks nothing like it. The only thing you can kind of play with is that it does have an opening and closing mouth, which the dagger was alive in the movie. It was actually voiced by Frank Welker, but this is bizarre to me. This is very bizarre because it looks nothing like the actual movie weapon. This is like I don't know. It's interesting. You can actually have the mouth open closed though, and you can have its eyes kind of fill out, but there's not really much to this. Of course, Shiwan Khan has a gimmick. Let's go ahead and work the sword into his hand. He's got a very tight grip. There we go. His old gimmick. Squeeze his legs. It really helps if you pull his arm up a little bit first. And now he can slash. He can slash at the shadow all day long. It's a very simple gimmick, but hey, it's effective. You do what you gotta do when you're fighting against the man who can cloud other men's minds. So we're gonna put you right back there. Up next, we have Battle Shiwan Khan with the red demon armor. Something, of course, he didn't have in the movie, and I have to wonder if it's something based from the comic strips or the serials, but it's not a bad look. I don't hate it. It's just, as an adult, I'm like, we didn't have that on film. As a kid, I probably would have loved this, but it's like, eh. I would have preferred to have, you know, a Peter Boyle figure to drive the cab. That's going to bug me forever. I just want a Peter Boyle to drive the cab. That's all I want. It's a simple request. But of course, he has all this little snap-on armor. You can, of course, take it all off. Pull off his chest piece. Take off his gauntlet claws. He's got his little leg armors. And there you go. So again, you could have this being your Shiwan Khan and have all those guys in the green be his Mongol warriors. That's absolutely fine. You could do that. I don't mind this figure at all. I think this whole outfit looks really good. If the hair ever comes unbraided, I'm probably gonna cry because I've seen eBay pictures where they've come undone and it's not pleasant. I don't want it to ever happen. But again, with the others, he has the same articulation. He's got the head can rotate, shoulder can rotate, legs can go forward and back. There's really no point showing it off. It's the exact same articulation. Just if you are getting this guy, make sure he has all of his armor bits. I bought this from a seller initially, and I'm not sure it really matters which leg these go on now that I'm actually playing with this. I think it does matter. There we go. And when I got mine, he was missing like half his armor bits, and you don't want that, so you gotta have him complete. He does have the same little slit in the back of his helmet that fits over his hair, and like he looks good. I'm okay with this being a villain, but it's like as Shiwan Khan in the battle armor, it's kind of I don't need it. It's okay. Put you right back there. So up next we have the Mongol Warrior. That is his literal name on the packaging, and he kind of resembles what I saw as Shiwan Khan's lieutenant. There's one guy that was like leading his foot soldiers. He kind of looks like him, but you could of course buy a bunch of these and army build your Mongol warriors if you so desire. It's very, very simple. I can't help but look at this guy and think of a wrestler. I'm not sure what it is, but it's just I see a 90s WCW wrestler with him. But of course he does have weapons. You have kind of two options to play with him. One, you have this really huge sword. That is not at all practical, but it's okay. And if you lift his arm up, you have to hold his legs firmly in place, and you can actually give him a slashing gimmick. So you can just, yeah. The more fun weapon, he has this bow, and I actually need to turn this around, if I can get it out. The little handle piece, you can flip around if you want to have him holding it left or right-handed. He comes with three arrows. You can store two on the bottom, and then this main one goes right in here. And it's got a slight groove, so you can actually fit it on the line. So we're going to give him his bow. And oh, you know what? The pictures lied. They didn't lie. I'm just stupid. He holds it in this hand, which, you know, just simulates as if he's pulling the arrow. But if you actually put the arrow in place, get it in there, line the groove up, you can actually. Boop. Yay! It works pretty well. It's not bad. I like it. This little line can come out if you are too forceful. It's just held in, just wrapped around the edge there. And if it does, you can put it right back on. It feels like it's some kind of plastic. And if it does split and tear, I'm sure you could find some kind of fishing line and just make your own to repair it. I want to go ahead and fire this again because I find it very enjoyable. So we're just going to put you there. And I can hit the camera. Nope. But it fires very, very well. I do like it. And of course, you can give him a sword if you want to have him just be a total terror. So there you go. There's your Mongol warrior. Last but not least is Dr. Mokino. Kind of like mosquito based on the spelling. Did not appear in the movie, but I do know he is a very big shadow villain. So I like the figure, but again, I would have wished we could have gotten more of the movie characters instead of this guy. With that said, I do like him. He does have a lot of fun features about him. He does have his attacking claw staff, which when he's holding it, you just pull the little stick on the back to make him grab things with it. So you can give him that if you so desire. He does have a shrunken head mace, which you can see there's a little face in there with his mouth all covered, and he holds that pretty well. And he's actually the only figure in the line that doesn't really have a gimmick. There's no, when you squeeze his legs or nothing, there's no spinny gimmick. He just holds his weapons and does whatever. However, my favorite accessory he comes with is a little teeny tiny voodoo shadow. which is not badly detailed for a very tiny 90s toy. And you can just wedge that into his hands and have him doing some voodoo against the Shadow. I'm torn. Like, he wasn't in the movie, but he is a fun figure. He does have an interesting look about him. And that's really it for this line. Tracking all these down was a lot of fun. I managed to get most of them from the same seller. And while I didn't have all of them as a kid, I have such an appreciation for them because of the fun I had for the ones that I did own. There's just this nice charm about toys from the 90s, especially Kenner, I would say. And people would argue that it's not just the 90s. It's even back for the Star Wars toys of the 70s and 80s. Kenner just did things that were special. Get up. You're wearing your cape. I'm not taking it off again. And I hope you guys enjoyed this little look at a toy line that I don't think many of you have probably seen, at least if you're a certain age. If you're my age or older, you probably had a couple of these. They were out in KB Toys an awful lot. And as you can tell from the packaging, they were there so long they were marked down $3 for $5. So they were out there, whether parents were buying them or not. But I guess that is it for this video, guys and gals. I hope you've enjoyed it somewhat. I've definitely had a blast talking about these. I'm looking forward to covering the vehicles next. The vehicles I played with many different toy lines. So it should be fun to show them off. As always, if you enjoyed this video and you want to see more, you can subscribe to the channel at the top there, which is the little bell, so you're notified when I post new content. I've got two of my previous videos on the side there. Down below, I have a Patreon and YouTube memberships that can unlock things like behind-the-scenes looks, upcoming video ideas, occasional bloopers, and our Discord server. I hope y'all have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.